Alright, how's it going, everyone? Welcome to Double Pebble and Selamat Hari Raya to everyone. So, I promised to start looking at the new World Legends. So, today we'll look at the one that I packed earlier this week, Gennaro Gattuso. So, I will be packing more and more legends as time goes on. So, I'll try to review as many of them as possible. We'll look at the stats of Gattuso first. This guy was a very fierce competitor during his heyday. I still remember the Man United match against AC Milan, and he was absolutely dominating the whole center of the pitch. Alright, 177 kg, he just has a lot of 7 in there. 92 strength, 99 stamina, okay, he'll never get tired. Good pace to him, 88 sprint, 86 acceleration. Is that accurate? I'm not very sure. 86 jump, agility is not that high, 82, and then his balance is crazy, 95. Sliding tackle is good, of course, that's expected. His ball control is surprisingly good, 88. That's important for your CDM because you don't want your CDM to lose the ball. And then marking is very high, tackling is very high, and his short passing is not bad, 88. That's why he's got the maestro style, I think, or trait, I think one of them. Long passing, nothing to shout about, heading, nothing to shout about. Interception is super high, 90. Positioning is not bad, 84. And then his reaction is 90. And most importantly, his crazy aggression is 99. As high as you can get already. Next, we look at the stars. He's got 11 of them, a lot, really. He's the perfect midfielder, perfect defender. He's got a maestro trait, which is the playmaker. And then his dribble master, sniper, tackle master, tactician, acrobatic, tanker, wing player, means he's a fast player. And area control. Work rate is mid-high. I generally like players with high defending work rate for defensive mid. And he's got a lot of trait. Injury free, dives in the tackle, argues. Second win means that you'll generally perform better when you're like losing in the last few minutes. And savings is like the tackles are nicer. Price, 5 billion. I'm not sure if this is like the stable price, but right now it's 5 billion. So over time it might get cheaper, I think. We'll have to see in our in-game analysis if he is the one that will solve your CDM problem. Right, so first thing that I noticed when I use him in-game is I like his positioning on the pitch. He is very disciplined on the pitch. So if you guys have used players like maybe David Luiz or Pique or Pogba in CDM, you know that they attack a lot. But for Gattuso, he doesn't really attack. So when you are attacking, right, he will always stay at the back, waiting to cut off any loose balls or fast counter attacks from your opponent. And because I use 3 midfielders, right, he's always the deepest lying of the 3. He doesn't really attack. And I think this is good for CDMs, because if your CDM bomb forward crazily, right, then your defense might be exposed unnecessarily. So this one is one of the biggest plus that I find when using Gattuso. In fact, I feel that he's more positionally disciplined as compared to even world legend Patrick Vieira. Next thing I noticed is his agility. This one maybe not so accurate because I've been playing a lot of FO4 nowadays, almost exclusively playing FO4. I only play FO3 for review purposes. But when I switch back to FO3, right, I feel that Gattuso is so agile and smooth in terms of his movements and twists and turning on the pitch. It's so easy to move him around. I think this one is because I've been playing too much FO4. Next, we talk about his ball winning ability. This one is his main selling point, okay? It's very obvious he's super strong in this department, with an aggression of 99, tackling of 91, strength of 92, and a bulky body. Not many players can take damage from him. So most of the time, right, you'll notice as soon as he touches the opponent, he gets the ball. So he's very efficient in terms of that. Next thing is his interception is very strong as well. I think this one is tied into his positioning. So like I said earlier, he hangs in front of the defenses when you are attacking. And I noticed that he has this anticipation and makes certain runs into certain position on the pitch in anticipation of the interception. He makes quite a bit of interception because there was one whereby the interception was very nice. When I was editing, I was slowly dissecting in and I saw him making that movement in front of the opponent and then just park there, and suddenly the ball comes. I didn't even control Gattuso at that point, so he has this innate anticipation in him. So like I said, he makes a lot of interception from loose passes as well as panic clearance. So if you're attacking and your opponent just clear, right, most of the time Gattuso will be at the back ready to mop up any kind of loose balls. He's also not slow as well. So there was one instance whereby he was in a foot race with an attacker. Generally, attackers are faster than defenders. And he managed to stay in front of his attackers at all times, which is very good. Weakness, he's only got one very big one, to be honest. The biggest one is his height issue. You've seen in the highlights, he's lost important headers against attackers, and that is going to be a big problem against the good ones, because if let's say your opponent keeper launches a long goal kick, if he loses that first header, most of the time you are on the back foot and you're under pressure already. So that is his biggest problem, because at 177 he's not going to win many headers in FO3. Goal scoring is also not his strong suit. As mentioned, he doesn't get forward unless you specifically send him up, so he doesn't really score many goals, but this is just a small problem. So overall, I will give him an 8 out of 10 because he is a pretty solid defensive midfielder, I have to say. I was actually concerned about whether he could win tackles on the pitch, or is he like a nearly man like world legend Petit due to his shorter legs and bulky frame. But I was actually surprised that he could perform so well on the pitch. Defensively, there's totally no problem to him. He performs up to expectation. The only concern is his height, which is still a very big factor in FO3. Not so much in FO4, but in FO3, height is everything. So is he worth it? 5 billion, to be honest, right? From all the CDMs that I've used so far in my FO3 career, I think in terms of defensive ability, he would be the second best CDM that I've used so far. The best is of course world legend Patrick Vieira, hands down. So I'll say if you can't afford Vieira, maybe Gattuso will be a strong alternative, but I did took a look at all the world legends that are available. Maybe Frank Rijkaard could be the best or second best, because he's 190, he's skinny, and he can play defensive mid. So we'll have to take a look at Rijkaard when I pack him to see where he stands amongst the CDMs. But as of now, currently, Gattuso is the second best. Alright, that is all I have for this review video. Hope you guys like it. I will probably go into doing FO4 player review as and when I get some good plus one players. So give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy my review video, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more content, and also check out our Facebook fan page as well, Double Pebble. The link is in the description box, and I'll see you next time.